Hi, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Buddy Talk with me, your host, Paul Pilelli. And I'm sitting here with Stray. As you can see, he's still up to his usual antics, sleeping. But before we go any further, before we get into this program, in fact, I'm starving. I don't know about you, but I haven't had anything to eat almost all day. The last time I ate was breakfast. Stray, I need your help, man. I can't do this without eating something. I'm starving, and you've always got food somewhere, right? There's gotta be something. Hello? Can you help me out? Starving. Food hidden away? I know you've got some food. Maybe under you? Leftovers? No? Oh, maybe in the kitchen. Should I look around in the kitchen? Okay, you know what? I'll contact C-Jack. Of course, he's always coming over here. Why I don't just call him and order something. Seafood, right? What should we get? Canceled? What are you talking about, canceled? Out of stock. Now what do I do? Now we're in it, Stray. We got no food. Oh, great, we have guests. Someone's here, I know that music. Shafira! Uh-oh,
hi.
We have guests! Woohoo! Shafira's here! Get up, Stray! Show her your moves! Come on, I've been teaching you.
I have you a move holding the bowl, Paul. Don't you see?
Wait, a bowl?
Yes!
Yes! What is it? I'm starving!
Me, of course.
I was so worried
that... you're on a diet, right?
I know, I dieted so much I forgot to eat.
Of
now I'm so hungry.
I have this edamame.
Wow, amazing!
I boiled it already.
Cooked? You put,
yeah,
you put a little bit of salt on it? Salt-based?
Yeah, salt-based.
Is that on it?
Yeah.
Ooh,
you know the lots of benefit from edamame, right? High protein, super high. It's basically it's categorized as superfood.
Fiber.
High protein, fiber as well, and then a good nutrition for your body. And this one is very expensive in some countries.
Really?
Yes. Especially in
Japan? I guess not.
Not Japan.
It's from Japan.
And what? I don't know. Probably some in Western country.
Really?
Like Canada.
Yeah.
Or maybe United States.
Makes sense. It's very long
or
travel.
Or Mexico, probably.
Yeah. I don't know if they eat edamame in Mexico. They got their own
they
beans.
They have like red beans.
They have lots of beans. They don't need edamame.
They don't
need
have
edamame
the green beans right here.
This is great. Thank you for this, by the way.
Yeah. So basically, Paul, speaking about edamame, why? Probably you wondering why I bring...
Kind of. I'm not complaining, but I'm curious.
You have a TikTok account, right?
Yeah, of course I do.
You know, the songs are keep playing every time we open the app. It's called Edamame.
I think
there's a song, it's called Edamame. By Baby Number One and Rich Brian.
Wow.
It's just stuck in my head, you know. I just stop thinking about the song and I keep like singing. Well, it's not singing. It's a rap song, basically. So.
You talking about Baby No Money?
Yeah, Baby No Money.
Yes,
Baby No Money
and
Rich Brian.
Yeah, of course.
Yes. Do you want?
It's everywhere.
Edamame, yeah, the song is called Edamame. That's why
right,
I'm here, because I got inspiration from them.
Okay, back. Let's give our viewers a little refresher.
The music video.
Yes.
Why not?
Let's
this
check
one.
It out.
Edamame.
Singing low while I pop a bottle off of ya. Chain swinging, clang clang, and it costs a lot. Bitch, I'm always at the guela, yeah. And you are not badass, beat. Keep on going till you hit the spot. Whoa, I'm a big bag hunter with the bow. She got a big bed, never drop it low. Mama called me and she happy with the grow. Never ever fall for a body that's a no.
Just pop the kidney about a million options. So just talking, I stop doing the gleaming. I'm rock arenas, bringing the peace. I'm bumping that park in the car, pretending I got all the eyes on me. Got a bad baby and she's independent. Too many people older than me, they're seeking attention. When they want me by the goofies, man, I should've listened. And the smell of the money, my strangest addiction.
She tit for dick, I let her lit. I had to dip, I'm on for fifth, I'm all rich now. I bought a whip, I paint a paint, it drives itself. The fuck you think, yeah, I'm rich now. Hey, little mama, yeah, you heard about me.
All right, that was the video, the latest video from Baby No Money. But
nice.
We have a special surprise for all our viewers for Buddy Talk. We're now connected with Baby No Money himself.
Whoa!
Say hello.
Hi.
Hi, baby, are you there?
Hello.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Good.
How's everyone doing?
Great. Thank you so much for joining us here today.
So good to see you. It's your bedtime there, right?
It's nighttime.
Yeah, it's my bedtime. I just made this light a little bit better with some Arm & Hammer and some tissue paper because it was a little too hot on me. So make do with what you got, right?
Really appreciate it. Thank you.
So speaking of heat, you were just in Indonesia not so long ago. It's a bit warm here this time of the year. Tell us about you. Is that your first time in Indonesia, and what were your first impressions?
My first impression is Beef Rendang goes crazy. I think the people are like some of the nicest people I've met in the world. Just like everyone. I didn't expect it to be that smoggy, Jakarta. I had no idea that it was like the most popular, like one of the most populated cities in the world. Like, I just didn't know that.
Right.
And it was a pleasant surprise. The food. I love Indonesian food. I love Asian food. So I was living in heaven for a little while.
Oh, wow. Really cool. For how long you stayed
it's a great
in
place.
Jakarta? For how long?
Honestly, I don't even remember. I think it was like 2 days or 3 days.
Oh,
but
okay.
Like every single thing I ate was just delicious.
Wow.
So I'm a fan and I will come back as soon as I can. Ooh.
Nice. Well, speaking about food, you also made a single called Edamame with Rich Brian. All right, please tell us more about the song.
You know, I just ate edamame today. Usually I don't eat edamame because I think it's kind of overpriced. And most restaurants, you know, you get like
true.
25 little beans for like for like $8, you know, usually, and it's like kind of pricey.
By the way, we want to take a second to introduce you to the third member of our show here. We didn't get around to it earlier.
Yeah,
this is Stray, by the way.
He fell asleep waiting for you, baby.
Yeah, he's on Canadian time, I think. Let's try to get a close-up of Stray.
There he is.
There you go. Rags to riches story. He was he's literally a stray cat before we found him and put him on TV. So let's get back to Shafira's question. Can you tell us a little bit? Continue your story. You're telling us about edamame and how expensive it is over there.
Yeah. So edamame is expensive, definitely. It's usually just not the best appetizer. Like, you know, typically it's like a Japanese restaurant or a Chinese restaurant, and like you can get like spring rolls or like dumplings for like an appetizer, and I prefer those. Just you know, I know I'm the one who made the song about edamame, sure, but like I prefer those. But it's cool. You know, I was always a really, really massive fan of Rich Brian. And, you know, just getting to work with him was kind of like a dream come true, because I unironically, like, would listen to his music all the time. And, you know, I would always be just putting on his music. And I was like, I never really expected to be able to make a song with him, but I did. And it was great. And when I sent it to him, he immediately was like, yo, I want to get on this, like, right now.
So we're going to talk a little bit more about a lot more similarities that I managed to find between you and Rich Brian. But in the meantime, there are a lot of rappers in Indonesia. I'm sure you got to meet some of them. You did a show with Ramen Girl, I believe it was her Going Girls production that did it as well. So we want to get your take on some other Indonesian rap acts that perhaps you may not have heard of. So we're gonna play it for you. Hopefully you'll be able to see it from where you are. Here we go.
We'd like to see your reaction.
Let's start with the first one.
For real, rapper-rapper bicara kosong. Mereka bohong, ngomong kosong. Para badut gotong royong di video kalian sombong. Dunia nyata kotong kosong. Kualitas bodong, kau pistol tanpa selongsong. Cari cengaku sedikit mesum. Tiap dengar omong kosong, punya pasti bangun. Kalian semua cuma badut tanpa kosong. Musik ini adalah obat penawar racun. Engkau bullshit, bullshit. Takkan bisa, no way, no way. Kami hantam, go away, go away. Sambil smoking all day, all day.
This is Tuan 13.
Yes.
His name is Upi. He's actually, he's very well liked here across the country. He calls himself something Sumatran, like the Sumatran tiger or something.
Yeah, Harimau.
So tell me a little bit, what's your first impression on Tuan 13?
First impression is music video is cool. He's incorporating cooking, so he clearly just likes cooking. also like, I like food, so he's already won me over. The music itself wasn't coming through as ideally as it should have with the ears, but it does sound sick. He said also that he was smoking daily, so he's definitely got something going on. So
I caught that too. That one will make it through the censor.
We have more. This is the second one.
Zaman perjuangan nanti merdeka, Jogja istimewa bukan hanya daerahnya, tapi juga karena orang-orangnya.
Jogja, Jogja, tetap istimewa, istimewa negerinya, istimewa orangnya. Jogja, Jogja, tetap istimewa, Jogja istimewa untuk Indonesia.
These guys, this is Jogja, a hip-hop foundation out of Yogyakarta. And a lot of their sounds, as you can hear, and even their lyrics, are based on using their local dialect, right. Their local language, their local, the Javanese way, the clothing, yeah. As you can see, yeah. And the yeah. instruments as well. So what's your take? That one sounds a bit different for you, I'm sure.
Yeah, no, I like it. It's super like regionalized, you know what I mean? Like it sounds yeah. like it's yeah. like what it should be. And I like the music video itself because it's like, it almost seems like, kind of, is it political? Is he like a political rapper? Like, or is it just like, he's just like, what's he saying in the song?
No, they just, actually it's just a general song, but they always worry, they're using local languages.
Yeah, they rap about their city, they rap about their history,
about their things history, like that. The culture.
And perhaps there is a political, I guess, undertone to the history of the
yeah, lyrics, exactly. Right.
Yeah.
All right,
one more.
I mean, yeah, he's showcasing the tradition, which is great, so.
Yeah.
All right, the last one.
Saya dengan masak tapi sani hari saya horas mandi ini kuan ganu pari si mora mampu saya pun putih lagi saya mora mampu turut horas jalan kaki
bolo boi do turu batak naro minar sitaro ami alerongan asa putra hari.
Okay, this one is a Siantar rap. It's a little bit more of a modern sounding. I would say it's probably more Western sounding, but he uses also a certain dialect,
local, yes.
Right? A local dialect.
Yeah. No, it's more
true. He's like the Indonesian like rapper Justin Bieber. He's sick. I like him.
You're right. Oh my goodness. I didn't realize. Right? Even he's got that. Sounds even a little
yeah, he's got that weird like the floaty melody. It's sick. Yeah.
Definitely cool. More radio friendly.
More radio friendly. Yeah. Yeah. That was
all right. If you had to collaborate with one of those three, were to give you, which one would you choose?
I would just collaborate with the first two for sure. Okay. I would do it on the same song. I get both of them on the same song.
Ooh.
Wow.
It'd be like
and then the interlude could be the last guy. He could be just talking. He could be saying something crazy. Something aggressive, I don't know, yeah. Yeah.
All right, we're going to take a short break here on Buddy Talk. Baby, don't go anywhere. We've got one more segment with you. We've got a few more questions to go over with you. So we'll be right back, guys, after this. Welcome back to Buddy Talk, everyone. Still with me, Paul Pilelli. We've got Shafira, my salsa instructor. Woo-hoo. We've got Stray, who is still fast asleep. And the one and only Baby No Money.
Yay!
So, What's good?
All right, so we talked a little bit about how you ended up connecting with Rich Brian. What was interesting to me is that Rich Brian, the first guy, I believe, that made his beats in the beginning, that produced his stuff, was his brother. And his brother actually doesn't have a background in hip-hop. In fact, he preferred music like EDM, electronic music, and trap. But he ended up making this really sick couple of really sick tracks for his brother, and that's how Rich Brian got started.
Yeah.
I read something similar about you as well, where you're, you know, growing up, you actually liked stuff like dubstep and house music before you even got into hip-hop. Can you tell me a little bit about your background and your influences and how it shaped you to become who you are today?
So I like kind of found myself barely ever listening to music when I was younger. I was homeschooled, so I didn't really have too many influences, just like overall. And then my brother, he went to high school and he ended up getting into like house music, and then he got into dubstep, and he was just like putting me on to music all the time. So through that, I was exposed through you know, exposed to a lot of new music and just like different genres and different sounds. And then, yeah, I kind of just fell in love with dubstep and I fell in love with bass music. And that's why I like a lot of my music has like bass undertones and it's like very bass present. Sometimes it's even house music, for instance, at a moment. And then what happened was I also then fell in love with Chief Keef and Gucci Mane and tons of other rappers, Mac Miller. And, you know, I started writing poetry. And through that, I just I kind of found myself making music with a bunch of my friends. And then through that, I became a rapper.
And also last month, in October, you released a new album titled Bag or Die. So please tell us more about the new album.
See, in my opinion, I wrote this album in like January and I'm over it. I'm already looking forward to writing new music and putting new music out. And, you know, it's a really good project. It's a really solid listen through. I think it's probably one of my most consistent projects and strongest full way through. And it took me a little while to write it. It took me a little while to get it out. But I'm excited for next year. I like this year is over in my opinion. And yeah,
wow, cool.
Next year's like a new fresh start. So, and like, I think, Rich Brian and I are going to work on music too. So,
I want to ask you about, I don't like to put music into categories.
Yeah.
You've been once quoted to say that you describe your music as oxymoronic rap. If our viewers that aren't familiar with that, that just kind of means like, it's like when you say an opposite, like two things. It's like saying skinny fat, right? Oh, like that's an oxymoron. Yeah. So you said your music is ignorant but melodic. Even that sounds like a jokey answer. How much truth is that? Is there to that statement? How would you describe your music? I mean, it's
those,
very hard.
Those statements. Yeah, those statements came from like 2016, 2017. So as far as the relevancy of how they stand up, I mean, unfortunately, they get quoted quite a bit. But I don't know. My music is just fun. It's very lighthearted. You know, but next year I'm going to traverse into like three different genres that I've never done before and really just try to hone in on becoming a more multidimensional artist. You know, I don't really know. It's very upbeat. My music is all upbeat and I don't personally like listening to music that isn't upbeat. I just kind of get bored of it. Maybe that's just because I like drinking coffee. So if I like drinking coffee, and I like being jacked up on things. Then, you know, I like, so maybe that's like where my personality comes into and like my, you know, my beliefs of what my music is, but I don't really know how to describe my music yet. And, you know, maybe next year I will be able to.
I'm kind of glad. I don't like it when you have to categorize yourself.
Exactly. Or define
thing.
By
like,
something,
yeah.
You know, categorize.
Yeah. And music
thing.
Should be uplifting, by the way. It should make you feel
something
happy.
That we can enjoy, actually, yeah. You know. Mm-hmm. And about the music itself, rap songs, well, if we take back from the roots, the rapper or hip hop artist usually wrote the song based on their concern about something or anxiety or about anything. Mm-hmm. Do you have any particular anxiety or worry or I don't know what's at the moment that you can probably turn to be a great song?
Not really. I'm relatively an upbeat person. Obviously, you know, being a normal human being, I have my anxieties and my stresses and my worries.
Right.
But I mean, like, I think the most overarching thing that I like try to like put into my music is like, we're all gonna die, so just have some fun. Is kind of the concept of Baby No Money, and like, you know, I'm super blessed to be in the position I'm in. Like, I'm on a tour right now, and we're doing like. I'm doing a show in Boston in New York of 5,000 people. Literally 5,000 people are coming to see my friend and I just say a bunch of nonsense on stage and just be us. And it's so cool and I'm so blessed to do it. And it's, you know, it's fantastic. So through that, it's just like I'm given this platform to be able to be a positive influence on like youth and people who look up to me. And it's like, just who cares? Have some fun. People take life way too seriously.
Yeah, I know, right?
Great.
Yeah.
Cool.
If that's kind of like a way to think about it, perhaps.
Nice.
Yeah. That's the way I like to look at life as well. I couldn't agree with you more. Don't take life so seriously, especially now that we're coming out of this
pandemic. Of course, because we have more questions.
We got time for some rapid questions for you. So we're going to give you a couple of options, and you're just going to choose one without thinking too much about it.
Pharrell or Usher?
Definitely Pharrell. There's no question.
Okay. Is there any particular reason?
I mean, him and Chad Hugo were nerd back then, and they were just the best to ever do it. There's no question.
Yeah, I think it's not a fair fight between Pharrell and Usher. Okay, how about this one's going to be harder for
Usher's great, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, of course.
Usher's great, don't get me wrong. But
this one, I think I can guess. Yes, this one, I think I can guess it, Paul.
No, nah, this one's going to be hard to guess. Okay.
Rich Brian or Young Gravy?
Oh man.
We thought we'd stump you.
Oh man. Yeah, you can't do that to me. I'm obviously partial to Young Gravy because he's my brother. But if I were to genuinely put on a song, I would probably put on if I was at a party, I would put on a Rich Brian song. Actually, no. There are some Young Gravy songs that I would put on. See, it's hard. It's really hard.
Say that, but like, right? Self-doubting about your choice. Like,
yeah. All right. Like Glow Like That is one of my like top like 30 songs ever, I think. I love that song. Okay.
So it's like a 51-49
song. 51-49, right.
Yeah.
All right. More?
Yeah, last one.
Piano or swimming?
Definitely, I am terrible at piano, and I am way better at swimming, but piano is just like, kind of like the roots of my music, my journey, so maybe swim, then play some piano.
Why not?
There you go. Have a little bit of both. Enjoy life. Don't take it too seriously.
But
It's nice to know that, you know, you say you had struggles even learning musical instruments the way, you know, other musicians did. But to be able to be where you are right now and be successful, that is obviously very motivating for those young, inspiring musicians out there. So real quick, before we let you go, last messages for your Indonesian fans. There's lots of them. And I don't know if you're aware at how your music is, because TikTok's really big here, social media is really big
here.
And I think Edamame, if I'm not mistaken, is like the top 10, one of the top 10 songs of TikTok. That's been used in Indonesia.
Really? I did not know that statistic. That's crazy. Yeah. That's dope. My main, what would I want to say? I mean, look, I'm coming back as soon as I can for B Friend Dang. So if you guys are in the town, come to the show and it was so good. I cannot even get over how delicious it was. Oh my God. And then the nasi goreng on like the street cart. Oh my God.
By the way, because I know in Toronto there's at least like 3 or 4, even in the downtown area, Indonesian restaurants. And there are a lot of Indonesians in Vancouver. Are there no Indonesian restaurants out there?
So I used to own this apartment downtown Vancouver. There was this like food court. There was an Indonesian restaurant.
Yeah.
I would just go in there and I would get rendang all the time. There's not too many like full blown like, oh, it's just like Indonesian.
Yeah.
It's kind of just like there's like a bunch of different cuisines at one restaurant type thing. But I mean, if I looked, I could definitely find it. I just like I don't look that hard. I love just going to the places and be like, okay, I know I'm eating the best of the best. Get it from the source. Exactly.
So forever memory.
That's right.
So glad that you had a great experience.
Yeah, we definitely can't wait to have you back. And I'm sure all your Indonesian fans.
Thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, congratulations.
No, thank you guys. Appreciate your time.
Yeah, take care, and we hope to see more of you in 2023.
Yay! All right.
So that's the end of our program.
Top 10 songs, right? On TikTok.
It's so big. There was one point in time when Instagram Reels first started. Every time I went to look for music to put on a reel, that was the number one song that was always suggested. They always suggested Edamame, over and over. I think I even used it in one of my reels because
it's stuck in our head right now.
Yeah, it's always stuck in my head. So So again, that was Baby No Money from Vancouver, currently still on tour. He's in Miami, Florida for another show.
Yeah.
Just had him here in Indonesia. It was so great to catch up with him. And you know, it's true what they say, Canadians are great.
Canadian, very nice. Yeah, when the door is open.
Especially if you need a door.
Yeah. And we're going to play the video, right?
We are, but before we do that, it's time for us to say goodbye first. So thank you for joining us for this episode of Buddy Talk. On behalf of Shafira, Stray, and the rest of us here on the Buddy Talk set and crew, we'd like to say goodbye, but don't forget to tune in every Saturday and Sunday night at 8 p.m. only on See Today for more fun guests and fun times here on Buddy Talk. My name is Paul Pilelli, signing off for now. We'll see you next time, and please enjoy this video, Baby No More.
Slow down, hold up, let me kick phone up, pussy boy shut up, fa la 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 la, fill my teacup, my girl monster, yeah she kinda stuck up, fa la la la. Your lady thirsty, go show mercy, she too curvy, controversy, suck my D, Kira Skirt, she some ass, she Eddie Murphy, call her mama, she call me daddy, she bad and bougie, down there, I'm poppin' tags, I'm poppin' cash, I'm in this bitch, make it slappish. I'ma wake on up, two, I'ma get my bag, three, I'ma bustin' up, four, I'ma blow that bag, five, don't regret that shit, six, I'ma taste my bitch, seven, we gon' cry a bit, eight, we don't give a shit, big game average, but I know how to thrust,
you know
my shorty bad and independent like Russ,
so do you want
40k, I brought my price going up,
you know I got it.
Start complaining, little bit shut the fuck up,
she too curvy, controversy, suck my D, Kira Skirt, she some ass, she had a Murphy, call her mama, she call me daddy, she bad and
mama called me, said she loves this new one.
I love you, mom.
We talking money, then consider it done.
That shit was easy.
I might be short like Tom, but I'm the top gun.
Mommy, impossible.
Goodness gracious, yeah, this shit going dumb.
So do you-